So you're editing your footage and you got the exposure how you like it for the overall image, but then you notice one little spot that looks way too overexposed. So let's look at how to correct multiple exposures in your shots. Hey everyone, Camber here, showing you how to use your camera to make good video. So if you're new, consider subscribing and also joining my private Facebook group where I can better answer your filmmaking questions. But when it comes to exposure, one of the most important things is to get it as correct as possible in camera for the best results. So if you need some help with getting it right in camera, then check out these videos here on exposure and camera metering to help you get the best results. However, there are still times when you may not notice that part of the image is overexposed. Like when you're trying to shoot a short film all by yourself that you're also acting in. And so you find yourself having to try to fix it as best as possible in post. So let's head over to the computer and start working on it. So we're here in Final Cut Pro looking at a few clips from my last short film, Bedtime, which I'll link down in the description if that's something you want to see. But I also made another video on exposure explaining all these different controls. So if you don't understand something I'm doing throughout this, then I'll also have that link down below so you can look at that video and it'll make more sense. So the first thing I'm going to do is hit Command 4, and that's going to bring up the inspector. You can also push this button here to do that. I'm also going to bring up Command 7. So here we have all the controls I already did on this video when I was color correcting it. And then over here we have our video scopes. And as you can see, part of this is quite a bit overexposed, as you can see there. So if I went into my color wheels and pulled down the highlights until that wasn't overexposed anymore, obviously it's way too dark and I don't want it to look like this. So this is where we're going to add another color wheel, or you could do color board, whichever you like better. I just prefer color wheels. And then I'm going to click on this and add shape mask. So that gives us this here. How this works is whatever correction you do is going to be in this inside area, and then this outside area you can adjust, and that controls how much it falls off or feathers from your correction. So I want it to go around that light up there. So what we're going to do here is change the shape, move it up here, make this a lot smaller. So that's about how I want it, and then this will adjust the rest. So what I'm going to do here is grab the highlights, and this is on the color wheels that has the shape mask. So I'm going to get the highlights and just pull this down until that gets to 100. So now, turn that on and off. You can see an obvious difference on this little dark area here when you first do that. And you can adjust that however much you want. If you put it out like that, then it really controls the fall off and looks pretty good. So that's pretty simple. It's still overexposed, but it's not quite as bright and doesn't attract too much attention. So here's another one. I've already done this clip, got it how I want, and you can see on the left, there's a lot that's overexposed. I'm going to take this back to here so the colors are off. So the same thing here, if I was to pull that down so that wall's not so bright, well, now they're a lot darker and I don't want that because I want it exposed more so for them. So we're going to do the same thing here. I'm going to add, I'll do a color board this time just so you can see the difference. And I'm going to add a shape mask. So this is where a change in the shape can come in handy. So I'm going to make this more of an oval shape, move it over here and change the angle of it, put it over on the wall, put it over the brightest part, and now we can take the highlight, pull that down. It's still overexposed, but it's not nearly as bad. And here's where, you know, if this was really close like that, then it's super obvious. So let's pull that out so it blends a little better. Controls the fall off. And now you can still tell there's a difference there, but when you're watching this, you wouldn't notice that because for one, you're looking at the kids, and so you don't notice it as much. But the other thing here is, you see on the video, I step in front of that area, so I don't really want it to stay like that the whole time. So what you can do here is we'll go frame by frame
And once I come into frame right there, I'm gonna take the B for the blade and cut it there. Now for this one, I'm gonna delete that color board that has the mask. So now it won't change the colors here when I'm covering that, but as I come in, it goes away. All the rest of the colors look normal. You probably wouldn't notice it since I'm wearing a black shirt anyways, but you would notice if I was wearing a different color. So here's one last example here. So coming in the bathroom, obvious from the video scope, right here, this light is overexposed. So let's do the same thing. I'm gonna go to my color wheels, gonna add another color wheel. So make sure we're working on number two so that we don't change the other one. Add a shape mask, make this smaller, put it over top of that light. We're gonna bring the highlights down till that's at 100. And then we'll click here to get off that and see the difference there. Not quite as bright and doesn't stand out as much. But the other thing here, as we go on with this clip, as I walk out the door, those lights are way overexposed. I don't really like that either. So I'm going to add one more. I'll do color board again this time. Add a shape mask. We'll change the shape of it. A little more square. Change the angle some. Bring it up over that brightest part. And then we'll bring that exposure highlights down. So it's right at 100. So now same thing before. Super bright, after not quite as bad. But what we're gonna do here again is, since it's only for part of the scene, I'm gonna start it right there. So I'm gonna hit B again to cut that, or Command B if you just wanna do it without having to click on the clip. And then I'll go click on this previous one. I'll take out that color board shape mask for the first half of the clip, so that now it only shows up when we get to there. So now nothing looks way overexposed in this clip. We can do a quick before and after. So that's with the two different color masks off. And we turn those back on. And just helps out a little bit overall, so there's not super bright parts of your images.
And that's it. We're simply exposing the overall image how we want and then using a color mask to fix the overexposed parts. And this works pretty easily with a stationary shot, but if you run into the same issue with a moving shot, you can still do the same thing, but you'll have to spend a lot more time keyframing your color mask throughout the shot, which I can cover how to do in another video if that's something you'd like to see. But if this video is helpful, then please help me out. Leave a like, subscribe if you haven't, and I'll see you soon.